we're here with Diane LaBelle, the director of the new First Nations Regional Adult Education Center here in Kahnawake. Diane, tell us a little bit about this venture.
Well, this venture has been about 10 years in the making now. There was a lot of discussion, there was a lot of questioning that took place as to why there were so many dropouts or so few graduates being able to filter into the job market. And as we saw that, you know, there was a problem with education outside the community, because it's always nicer to stay in your community with your own. The whole idea of having a First Nations Regional Adult Education Center came about. And negotiations with the government, and we're finally promised two of them, one Francophone and one Anglophone. And so the Francophone Center opened up last September in Lac-Simon, and this is the opening of the English Center here, and then again in Lac-Simon on October 29th. So this center will be catering to those who are seeking the academic background to finish their high school leaving certificate, accredited by the MELS. The students who are looking simply to get the prerequisites to get into a vocational program, we offer that as well. We also offer courses to those individuals who need extra credits in specific areas like science or math to get into some very specific CEGEP courses. We have not started the program for general interest courses, but we will be looking at that in October. Language classes, culture classes, Native history, these are all things that are there on our curriculum, and we're just excited, you know, to get those thrown.
We started 3 weeks ago. I think last week was the first week that we had the students in. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so it is week two and it's going good.
Okay. It's going good. What are you doing here?
I'm teaching history. Our history, Native history.
Okay.
Yeah. I told them in the beginning, during the interview process, I said, well, if I'm going to do this, I said, we got to tell our history from our perspective. You know, we can't tell it from the outside talking about us. We're gonna learn about who we are. So everything that happened throughout history, we're gonna put it all in perspective to where we are at right now, how everything led to right now. Mm-hmm. So that's the goal. You know, before we get started with the history part, I thought it was important that we have to get them grounded in identity first. They got to know who they are first. So the first things that we're going to be covering here is creation story, ceremonies, and great law. The reason for the creation story is that it's said that to truly understand a people, you have to look at their creation story first, because in there, it gives all your instructions. It gives what kind of person that you should strive to be. It tells you who you are, who your people are, and your place in the world. So what we're going to do is we're going to ground them first in their identity, and then we're going to start talking about history.
My name is Toby Pilon, stand up. The reason I came back to school is to finish my grade 10 and 11. I went into trades before and it didn't work out, and they started this up, and I came the first day and it was very comfortable and the atmosphere is very good. And for anybody else, I recommend coming, doesn't matter what age, because everybody is very respectful, everybody is very determined on getting their goals done. The staff are very pleasant. They're if you need any help, they're willing to help 100%. You get free periods too, that if a teacher's available, they will help you. They will take the time to sit there, and whatever you need, they will be there. They're great. Some of them I've known from survival school, and other ones I've just met. But everybody works great with everybody else. And like I said, it's very comfortable, nice atmosphere, and you can actually get your work done, and it doesn't feel like high school.
I'm very enthusiastic. I think education is the cornerstone of our continued development. Our youth need to stay in school, number one. And if they don't, now they have an option. I'm speaking to Diane. She's trying to work herself out of a job. Hopefully there won't be a need for continued education. All of our youth will graduate high school and continue into CGIP and college and university. But right now, this is a step in the right direction. We're glad and welcome the partnership with Listigouche, hoping to attend their opening on the 29th. I think this is great for our community.
Does the Mohawk Council have any involvement with this project or any financial support that they're lending?
No, it's funded through the regional offices here and the Ottawa office that's in Quebec City and the provincial ministry, but we had an initial role in saying that we deserve this. Ganawage needs to be looked at as one of the pioneers, whether it's in education or any other field. That was our role, just to support Diane and the center's role for establishing it here in Ganawage. For our Ganawage youth, I think it's the career path to choose, regardless of what career you do choose. You need to have an education to be successful in today's world.
If you haven't made the step to get back to school, it is, I know it's frightening, but we're going to try and make it as easy for you as possible. We're here, and the staff is very welcoming, and if you aren't quite sure about that, ask a student who's already here, and they'll tell you that this is their place, and they're comfortable here, and that's wonderful.